Hi friends, welcome back to CSS Zero to Hero. This series is for beginners who wants to learn CSS. In this video, I'm going to talk about another important concept in CSS, position. Let's start. The position CSS property sets how an element is positioned in a document. Elements are positioned using the top, bottom, left, and right properties. However, these properties will not work unless the position property is set first. For the position property, we can give 5 different values. They are static, relative, absolute, fixed, and sticky. HTML elements are positioned static by default. Static position elements are not affected by the top, bottom, left, and right properties. An element with position static is not positioned in any special way. So let's see into position fixed. An element with position fixed is positioned related to the viewport, which means it always stays in the same place even if the page is scrolled. The top, right, bottom, and left properties are used to position the element. Let me show you an example. I have created a div. I have added some width, height, and background color, and so we can see this. Now let me add some height to the body element, and so the page scrolls. And so if I scroll the page, we can see this div element is also getting scrolled along with the page. Now let me give position fixed to this div element. Now this is fixed related to the viewport. And so if I scroll, we can see this element is fixed now. I have not given any values for top, left, bottom, and right. That is why we are seeing some space here. If I give top 0 pixel and left 0 pixel, we can see now the div is moved to the top left corner. In case, instead of top 0, if I give bottom 0, we can see our div is moved to the bottom, but still it is fixed. Another thing we need to note here is, when we specify both top and bottom values, always top gets the priority. And when we give values to both left and right, left gets the priority. If there is no top value, only then bottom value get into effect. And similarly, when there is no left value, only then the right value get into effect. Hope you understood. Now let me explain about position absolute. An element with position absolute is positioned relative to the nearest positioned ancestor instead of positioned relative to the viewport. However, if an absolute position element has no position ancestors, it uses the document body and moves along with page scrolling. Let me explain. Here we can see this is fixed. And so when we scroll, this div is not scrolling because it is fixed relative to the viewport. Let me change this to absolute. We can see the position of this div is not changed. However, if I scroll, we can see this is moving. That means this is not fixed. Let me explain with another example so that this will be clear. Let me create two divs, first and second. And let me put this div inside the first div. Okay, and for the first and second div, let me give some height and background color. So that we can see the difference. Here we can see the red div is positioned as fixed. Let me change that to absolute. Now also no change, because as there is no position ancestor, it is positioned related to the body element. Only difference is, if we scroll now, we can see it is scrolling along with the page. So how can we create a positioned ancestor? There comes position relative. I can add position relative to the parent of this div, which is going to be this div with class first. Now we can see the red div is positioned relative to this first div. Earlier it was in the extreme corner of the body element. But now we can see it is positioned to the extreme corner of this parent div element. If I move this to the second div and if I add position relative to the second div, you can understand better. First let me move this div to second div, and if I refresh, we can see this is still here because this time we haven't specified position relative. And so it is positioned related to the body element. Now I am going to apply position relative to the second div. Once I applied, we can see this is positioned related to this second div. This is how position absolute works. Finally, we have position sticky. An element with position sticky is positioned based on the user's scroll position. A sticky element toggles between relative and fixed, depending on the scroll position. It is position relative until a given offset position is met in the viewport. Then it sticks in place, like position fixed. If I give position sticky here, you can understand. Let me scroll. We can see it is behaving like position relative and it scrolls along with the page. And when it comes to top 0, it sticks there. And when it meets the bottom of that parent div, again it scrolls with the page. This position sticky will be used to create some movable header which should be fixed in the top when we scroll down. Hope you understood about position sticky also. And when we discuss about position property, we have to discuss about zindex property also. Let me show you another example to explain about the zindex property. Here I have used position absolute to position these three divs related to the parent div. And so we can see this. Absolute position elements are removed from the normal flow and can overlap elements. And we can use the zindex property to control the stack order of the elements. Here we can see blue div is in the top of the stack, red is in the bottom of the stack, and the green is in between red and blue. I am going to give you a zindex value 1 to the green div. Now we can see green is moved to the top. I am going to give a higher zindex value to red. Now red comes to the top, blue is in the bottom. Let me give value 2 to blue. Now we can see blue comes between red and green. We can also give negative value to zindex. This is how we can use the zindex to rearrange the stack. Hope you understood about zindex. Before we close, let me also explain one more concept to you. Let me add a width of 600 pixels to the first and second div. Let me refresh. And so we can see this is having position fixed and we have given a fixed width of 250 pixels. A question to you. What will happen if I change this width to 50%? We can see it is taking 50% of the viewport width. And so if I resize the window, we can see this width is also getting changed. Okay, another question to you. I am going to change the position fixed to position absolute. Now what will happen? Let me change and show you. Now also no change, because we don't have a position ancestor. So this time also, it is going to position relative to the body. Let me add position relative to the second div. Now we can see it is taking 50% width of the parent div instead of viewport. And so if I resize the window, we can see the width is not changing. Hope you understood. See you in my next video. Please don't forget to like this video, subscribe my channel and support me. Thank you. Bye.